arguably even more tragic than Schenck v. United States are the Comstock laws, a horrible piece of postal censorship that was meant to protect against, let's see what they call it. Oh yes, it was illicit to send obscene, lewd, and or lascivious materials through the mail. And now, you might say, oh, so it's just another anti-pornography law. Not just anti-pornography. Information on birth control? Banned. Information on abortion? Banned. Condemning marital rape? Banned. So, on March 3rd, 1873, Anthony Comstock, founder of the New York Society for the Suppression of Vice. Oh yes, vice. What a horrible thing, because having sexual relations, or talking about sex, or using dirty words, like the ones George Carlin found, is such a horrible crime that obviously will corrupt the children and destroy the moral basis of society. So, Comstock had this law passed by Congress. And let's examine some of what it says, shall we? That whoever with... Okay. So, he shall be imprisoned at hard labor in the penitentiary for not less than 6 months, nor more than 5 years for each offense, or fined not less than $100, nor more than $2,000 with costs of court. Okay, so that's your, bit of info. That's your degree of punishment. Another interesting victim of this law? Comstock considered a book by Leo Tolstoy to be obscene, but once again, his main target was contraception, because that was something he associated with sexual impropriety and with prostitution and with all this immorality. Now, of course, it would be foolish and dishonest to say that there wasn't backlash against the Comstock Law. The noted playwright George Bernard Shaw, when asked why he did not visit America, said the following: "The reason I do not go to America is that I am afraid of being arrested by Mr. Anthony Comstock, imprisoned like Mr. Moses Harmon. If the Brigands can, without any remonstrance from public opinion, seize a man of Mr. Harmon's advanced age and imprison him for a year under conditions which amount to an indirect attempt to kill him, simply because he shares the opinion expressed in My Man and Superman that marriage is the most licentious of human institutions, what chance should I have of escaping? No thank you. No trips to America for me." And he was not alone in his condemnation of this. In Emma Goldman's essay, The Victims of Morality, she very harshly criticized Comstock. Goldman is one of the best anarchist philosophers, by the way. You should read some of her. She said, "Not so long ago, I attended a meeting addressed by Anthony Comstock, who has for 40 years been the guardian of American morals. A more incoherent, ignorant ramble I have never heard from any platform. The question that presented itself to me, listening to the commonplace, bigoted talk of the man, was how could anyone so limited and unintelligent wield the power of censor and dictator over a supposedly democratic nation? True, Comstock has the law to back him up. 40 years ago, when Puritanism was even more rampant than today, completely shutting out the light of reason and progress, Comstock succeeded, through shady machination and political wire-pulling, to introduce a bill which gave him complete control of the Post Office Department, a control which has proved disastrous to the freedom of the press, as well as the right of privacy of the American citizen." And, of course, she goes on to utterly annihilate all sorts of moralism, and it's brilliant. And I think she also called Mr. Comstock a moral eunuch, which I find quite amusing. And in closing, I have the following message to all censors.